वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट वंस अगेन द लेसन ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिजीजेस एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनिटी. एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनिटी हैज़ टू कंपोनेंट्स, द ह्यूमोरल इम्यूनिटी और एंटीबॉडी मीडिएटेड इम्यून सिस्टम एंड सेल्यूलर इम्यूनिटी और सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यून सिस्टम. Today we are starting with antibody mediated immune system. It consists of antibodies, a specialized protein produced in the body in response to antigen that circulates in the body fluid like blood plasma and lymph. Word humor pertains to fluid. B lymphocyte, that is B cell, produce antibodies and that regulate humoral immunity. The T lymphocyte themselves do not secrete antibodies but help B lymphocyte produce them. Certain cell of the bone marrow produce B lymphocyte and mature there. Since B lymphocytes produce antibodies, therefore this immunity is called antibody mediated immune system. Humoral immunity or antibody mediated immune system provides defense against most extracellular bacterial pathogen or virus that infect through respiratory and intestinal tract. The binding of antigen on the surface of B cell causes the cells to get activated, resulting into division of B cell and formation of clones. These clones give rise to plasma B cell and memory B cell. Plasma B cell is short-lived and secrete large amount of antibodies in response to antigen binding. Some of the activated B cells don't differentiate and act as memory B cell. These cells usually remain dormant until a new lot of same antigen takes entry into the body. Cell-mediated immune system is of two types. We know that lymphocytes are the immunocytes, which are of two kinds, B lymphocyte and T lymphocyte. It is the part of cell mediated immune system. A healthy person has about trillions of lymphocytes and are of two types, T lymphocyte or T cell and B lymphocyte or B cell. As we know, both types of lymphocytes and other cells of immune system are produced in the bone marrow. The process of production of cells of immune system is the bone marrow is called hematopoiesis. Because T lymphocytes mature in thymus, this immunity is also called T cell immunity. The T cell play two important function, that is the function of effector and the function of regulator. The effector function includes cytolysis, destruction of cells by the immune process. Cells infected with microbes and tumor cells and lymphokine production. The regulatory functions are either to increase or suppress other lymphocytes and accessory cells. As far as the type of T cells and their function is concerned, these are of four types. First one is helper T cell. Helper T cells are most numerous of T cells. They help in the functions of immune system. They produce a growth factor that stimulate B cell proliferation and differentiation and also stimulate antibody production by plasma cells, enhance activity of cytotoxic T cell. The next type is the cytotoxic T cell. These cells are capable of killing microorganisms and even some of the body's own cells directly, hence they are called killer cells. Antigen receptor on the surface of cytotoxic cells cause a specific binding with the antigen. Cell after binding the cytotoxic T cells secrete hole forming protein called perforins that punch large round holes in the membrane of the foreign cell. This then fluid flows quickly into the cell from the interstitial space. In addition to cytotoxic T cells release cytotoxic substances directly into the foreign cell, almost immediately the foreign cell becomes greatly swollen and it usually dissolves shortly thereafter. Thus, they destroy the body cells infected by virus and attack and kill bacteria, fungi, parasites and cancer cells. The last before last we have memory cell. These cells are also formed by T lymphocyte as a result of exposure to antigen and remain in the lymphatic tissues, spleen, thymus, lymph node. These recognize original invading antigens even years after the first encounter. These cells keep ready to attack as soon as the same pathogen infects the body again. They proliferate and differentiate into cytotoxic T cells, helper T cells, suppressor T cell, and additional memory cells. The last one is suppressor cell or regulatory T cell. These cells are capable of suppressing the functions of cytotoxic and helper T cells. They also inhibit the immune system from attacking the body's own cells. It is believed that suppressor cells regulate the activities of the other cells. For this reason, the suppressor cells are classified as regulatory T cells. That's all in this video. Thank you.